By Tuesday. Back to you.
Well, the engines for the Artemis mission that will put the first woman and the first person of color on the moon are under construction right here in California.
And KTLA 5's Gayle Anderson takes us inside the aerospace facility of Aerojet Rocketdyne.
This is the kind of engine that's being worked on here at Aerojet Rocketdyne, here right up under our noses in the Canoga Park, Chatsworth area. Jeff Zotti is the senior director of the RS-25 program. Yikes. And it's not just one engine that's being used for this program. There are four, I'm learning.
That's exactly right, Gayle. There's four RS-25 engines that power the Space Launch System rocket. And so the nozzle that you see behind us is just like the nozzle that's on our four engines at Cape Canaveral, ready to launch.
This is the kind of testing that's going on. The force, the heat, the intensity. I don't know how we can make anything, wrong pronoun, how you can make anything that can sustain all of that.
Yeah, well, we say at Aerojet Rocketdyne, you can't get to the moon without going through Los Angeles. And right here in our Canoga Park facility, we make some of the main components of the RS-25 engine, including our RS-25 nozzle. And actually, last week, we completed the wet dress rehearsal at Cape Canaveral. We fully loaded the rocket with propellants. We completed about 90% of the objectives. And now we're ready to roll back to the vehicle assembly building, and we're preparing for launch.
Stop it! Really?
really. And so, in probably early August or late August or early September, that rocket will be going, making a lap around the moon and verifying that the rocket meets all requirements, and then the Orion module will re-enter the Earth's atmosphere.
Now, we have some animation of this so people can understand, especially we civilians, how this works. You just don't look at the moon and you go straight to the moon. There's geometry and algebra involved in this. You have to kind of whip around the Earth first.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And most of the rockets that you hear about that launched today launched to about 200 miles above the Earth. This rocket is going to go 240,000 miles from Earth. It's going to make a loop around the moon, just as you described. And when it re-enters the Earth's atmosphere, it's going to be traveling at over 17,000 miles per hour. So that heat shield that will eventually protect the astronauts, that'll be the most important test of this launch.
Oh my gosh. And now this first launch, no people, just a test.
That's exactly right. The second launch of the Space Launch System rocket will be with astronauts. And during that launch, astronauts will travel deeper into space than any other humans in the history of our planet. But first, we've got to make sure the rocket's ready.
Oh, there's no getting to the moon without going through Los Angeles. At the Aerojet Rocketdyne Complex in Canoga Park in Chatsworth, Gayle Anderson, KTLA 5 News.